I'm very, very pleased to say that this is yet another one of the many free public events that we've been able to mount and produce in conjunction with the Shashin Festival. I'm very committed to the idea of making these events as open to the public as possible, as free as possible, and I'm delighted that ICP has been very, very generous in providing a space, and we also have the cooperation of Christopher Phillips today to bring this wonderful scholar to New York. I call him my sensei, Ryuichi Kaneko. He's been extremely influential in opening my eyes in terms of what's happening when we look at Japanese photography, and in particular through the form of the photo book. Kaneko-sensei's work over decades has involved him being a curator from the very beginning at the Tokyo Metropolitan Museum of Photography. He's been responsible for countless headline exhibitions and one-man exhibitions of great scholarly value that have helped establish a discourse about Japanese photography with many of the living masters from the field. He's also independently been operating as a scholar, collaborating with many different collectives over the years, and that has also helped stimulate and continue the feed of enthusiasm and excitement about Japanese photography. And also, he in the late 80s, he wrote a book that's now out of print and obscure to find, about independent photography galleries that were active in the late 70s and early 80s of Tokyo. These are spaces that were independently operated by and for photographers. They didn't have a commercial intent. They were just meant as a space for photographers to show their own work. And that is a great, I bring that up as an example is because it explains the DIY impulse of Japanese creators and Japanese photographers, and also scholars devoted to that field. So I see Kaneko being someone who has a great footing in the institutional world of museums and curatorial studies, but also is a DIY scholar. And now that he's now no longer a full-time curator at the Tokyo Metropolitan Museum of Photography, I'm very pleased to say that he's has much more time to do things like this, participate in this festival. And I'm very, very curious to see over the next few years what kind of independent scholarship he produces. So for today, he's going to give us a one-hour crash course on the topic that he's best known for, but this is just one of the many nuggets in his pouch of wisdom. So without further ado, I will introduce, all right, change of signal. Without further ado, I will introduce Kaneko Ryuichi, please.
Good morning. I will introduce the Japanese photo book speech. This speech in primary in 1960s and 40s is yesterday I speak in a New York Public Library symposium. In this speech, I will do the beginning of Japanese photo book to the 1960s and 70s. By photographs, I mean collection of photographs that published in Japan, primarily during the 1960s, that I say. When we talk about the photo books and their role in the history of photography, that question that always come up is, what is photo books, and why photo books for Japanese? It's hardly new to send the art books consist of photographs introducing works of art, but they are not my topic today. Books are photographic technique, like how to take a portrait, or how to take a landscape, or how to take others. And also for photographs, those books. But I won't be talking about them either. My purpose is here is explore the role of the photo books played in photographic expression in Japan. Primary post-era. In the post-war period, photo books became that quintessential from which individual Japanese photographers expressed themselves. They are amazing development within the framing they provided. Realism photographic movement launched in the 1950s by Domon Ken and Kimura Ihei. Spurred the development of the photo books. These photographers realized that displaying their work in exhibition of original print made them accessible only to the handful of authentics. But in pre-war Japanese amateur photographers playing that art photography for their sake. In that time, exhibition by original print is mainstream. That photographs printing is very rare because the cost is too expensive. Or editors had the power to the publishing or not. These photographers realized that displaying their work in exhibition original print made them accessible. Those photographers were driven by the idea that they had to establish their style to having photographs printed and made accessible to a mass audience. Their thinking drew on ideas that began to appear during the formative period of modern photography in the 1930s. Those ideas that living heritage of young photographers in Japan today. So here, I want to first briefly explore the origin of the photo books in Japan and then how it developed. My focus in this short introduction will be more on how the photo books became the type of publication it is rather than on question of photographic expression. Then I will turn to the photo books published during their golden age, the 1960s and 70s, and focus on the question of photographic style or expression. The context which photo books were first produced in Japan had never been discussed with their clarity this question deserved. My personal view is that its origin began to emerge in late Meiji, toward the end of 19th century. One example is a photographic album of the Japan-China War. This book was printed by Crotype. This album published by Ogawa Kazumasa, who organized the Japanese Army Photography Unit at the request of the Army Land Survey Department. All the outbreak of China-Japan War, this volume was published in 1895. Not only is every photograph in this album accompanied by a title and the captions of photographs, this. This is title and this is caption. And this is same one. Where? Okay, I start. Each photograph is also accompanied by publication data, copyright holder, and publishers and printer. This left side is the same. That shows those names. In modern photo books published in Japan, thank you very much. These are copyright holder and publishers. In modern photo books published in Japan, that information usually appears on the last page of the book's colophon. In its format, this album resembles a collection of ukiyo-e prints. In other words, it is clearly a collection of individual photographs, individually published, each work in its own right. When we look at this album, we see a single bound volume inside. However, it's fundamentally different from today's photo books. We do tend now, though, to look at this album as though it were unified work instead of collection of individual photographs. In a sense, this printed album could be said to be the original form from which the photo books developed. But we should, it seemed to me, draw distinction between this China-Japanese War volume and photo books. It is a photographic album, not photo book. This album by Ogawa published in 1904-1905 during the Russo-Japanese War, this. Also belong those photographic album category, I say. This is the title pages, and this is the pages of photographs. The same, no publication data, but the same titles and same title in Japan and same title in English. This book is printing using half-tone printing instead of quarter-type printing. Because this is very printing style different, is very important. Because I say Ogawa Kazumasa introducing quarter-type to Japan from United States, and also he introduced half-tone printing to Japanese by Ogawa. Also, the two printing is for photographs, not letterpress. So those half-tone printing, they could be published in larger numbers than quarter-type printing. Now, however, I want to turn from documentary photography to photography as a form of artistic expressions. This. In Japan, the art photography movement known as the pictorialism began at the end of 19th century, mid-Meiji era. It achieved that definitive form at the start of the 20th century. Photographers who embraced pictorialism published volumes that more closely resemble what we now call photo books. The most clear example are Fukuhara Shinzo's Parierasen. This is a book, a slipcase of that book, and this is a cover, and this is the pages. And also, I want to introduce Kakefuda Isao's photographic album by Kakefuda Isao. This is cover, and this is pages of that Kakefuda's book. Fukuhara's Paris Eras Seine is made up of 20 colotype prints and was published in 1923. By Shashin Geijisha, the Photographic Art Society of which Fukuhara was founder. Kakefuda's photo books published in 1924, is made up of 24 colotype prints. Fukuhara and Kakefuda's closely resemble Alvin Langdon Coban's 1909 collection of London, which contained 20 photogravure prints. This similarly natural one, since Fukuhara's group had published Coban's work in their photo magazine, Shashin Gages, the photographic art. And Kakefuda is also the member, same group. And he's one of founders. In both Fukuhara's and Kakefuda's photo books, we see the photographs as though inserted in frames and then bounded together. Publication data is not provided for the individual prints as it's the album from the China-Japanese War. But the treatment of the photographs is similar. In Japan, new style of photography called Shinko Shashin, literally that new photography or modern photography. Those modern photography movement emerged in 1930s in Japan. When we look at the collection of photographs published during this period, what do we see? This new photography was strongly influenced by the Bauhaus and Neue Sachlichkeit movement in Germany. While drawing that attention to the mechanical nature of photography, these movements also explored how photography could become a sophisticated medium in terms of both technique and design. One of this era leading photographers who was Horino Masao. He active in Tokyo. An example epitomized his work is camera eye iron construction. This is a left side is a front cover, right side is a back cover. In this collection, we can see the influence of Albert Rengerpach, German photographer. Horino's photo book is, however, distinctive in its design. In it, we see a dynamic visual sense in the cropping of the photographs, in layout design of same of each pages, like this. This is not found in Rengerpach's iconic Die Welt ist schön, The World is Beautiful, published in 1928. Another respect in which Horino's and other new photography books are strikingly different from collection produced during the era of pictorialism is their sequence. Using two page spreads as the basic unit. And another Japanese photo book, which not only exemplifies this era, but is seen worldwide as truly unique, is Koichi Kansai photographer, Japanese Western area, Koichi Kiyoshi's Early Summer Nervous. very famous photo book in this era. This photo book published in 1933 at the photographer's own expense. This collection has an aluminum cover, this, and the spiral binding you can see in the right side of books. Another profoundly interesting point is its use of crotype printing. This process is a flourished in era of pictorialism. We believe a long time this book is half-tone printing. When we make a facsimile edition of this book, we talk with a printer. We can discover that this book was crotype printing in Kansai. It's very interesting for me. There are 10 photographs in all, to each of which the photographer has attached a poetic caption. This is tearing myself. In contrast to Horino's use of two pages spreaded, here each photograph is presented on separated pages, individual. That is, while the design and photographic expressions are modern, the printing and the way in which the photographs are displayed are characteristic of pictorialism. And reportage photography is another style pursued by modernist photographers. During the 1930s, photographs in this style appeared primarily in magazines intended for the Japanese readers. Individual photo books of this type are published for foreign readers as propaganda, not for Japanese readers. One exception is Kumagai Morichi's book titled Ochi Village, Photographic Documents of a Rural Village, published in 1938. There are 175 pages in all, with an all two-page spread. Kumagai was an amateur photographer, an elementary school teacher, who documented everyday life in the village where he taught. This collection was published as Japan was on the verge of going to war. But it was not propaganda. It was permeated with the spirit of a true grassroots document, which happened to take the form of photo book. It was highly praised when published. This spread page is a photograph in elementary school where he taught. During the late 1930s, Japan went to war. Reporters flourished in propaganda directed at other countries. Collections published by professional photographers were pressed into propaganda mold. One example, Kimura Ihei's Japan Through a Laika. Composed of 100 photographs, it is published in 1938. Kimura began his career as a reportage photographer, photojournalist. He was influenced by Natori Yonosuke, who introduced to Japan the reportage photography methodology he had learned in the early 1930s while studying he was in Germany. This spread pages is introducing a Japanese traditional style, traditional girls kimono style. Left side pages is a famous woman actor Setsuko Hara. And this spread is introducing elementary school. And also the other one, this book. This book by Watanabe Yoshio. He is also important reportage photographer, same as Kimura. This Bunraku is a photo book that introduced the Japanese traditional culture for foreigners as propaganda. And next, I want to introduce that incredible photo book. It's difficult to save the photo book, titled Nippon. Nippon, a Nation in Panorama, published by Kokusai Bunka Shinkokai, the International Culture Promotion Society, meaning Now Japan Foundation. This was unique photo book comprised by Nippon Kobo. This Nippon Kobo was established by Natori in 1934. It was not a coffee table book to casually leaf through. The images, if we spread it on a table like this, but this is different. This is exactly right. It's long, this photograph, the long accordion folded pages, but intend to be placed for display and appreciation on pedestal, almost like a folding screen. It was, in effect, composed photographs, a mini photo mural, like some exposition. It was propaganda introducing both modern and traditional Japan to the outside world. The montage was created by Kumada Goro, using photographs taken by such leading reportage photographer as Domon Ken and Kimura Ihe and Watanabe Yoshio. The works we have examined so far are only a fraction of the photo books published in pre-war and wartime in Japan. They should help us to understand, however, the development of books published in Japan from formation of the modern photography movement to the impact of the war. Following surrender in 1945, Japan embarked on the road to democracy. Tokyo, fall of 1945, is one of earliest photo books in post-war era, photographed by Kimura Ihe and Kikuchi Shunkichi. This is published in English-Japanese co-language edition. For people of the occupation forces, this was printed water gravure printing, so effort is very poor. But post-war Japanese photo books started from this book. And in 1950, the Japanese photo condition started as a start of realism photo movement. The 1950s is while Japan was still under the American occupation. Domon Ken and Kimura Ihe were the two key figures in this movement. Both had been active as professional reportage photographers during the 1930s and had been involved in shooting propaganda photographs during the war. After reflecting regretfully upon their experience, they became advocates of realism, a photographic movement whose aim was capture social reality unflinchingly. Domon's famous phrase, an absolute snapshot, absolutely unstaged, expressed this desire to expand from photography the staged element used in a photograph for wartime propaganda. And research, Domonkin's very first solo photo book, is a typical example of photo books from the 1950s. This was published in 1953, the year the occupation ended. Explaining this stance in this book, Domonkin said that portraits were personal records of the individual historical and social existence. In Domon's thinking, photography is a social artifact, the portrait reportage. And this is famous Japanese painter Ryuzaburo Umehara in his studio. This photograph was photographed in pre-war. In this research, combine the pre-war work and the post-war work. Let us stand now to Hiroshi Hamaya's Snowland. This Snowland is also pre-war work and after-war work. This collection was published in 1956. As a special issue of magazine Kamera Mainichi, but this issue came in extraordinary slipcase and hardcover. Those photographs were reproduced using the very highest quality of photogravure printing. Hamaya began his career as a freelance reportage photographer active in Tokyo in the latter half of the 1930s. Hamaya is a second generation of Japanese reportage photographer. First generation is Kimura Ihe and Horino Masao. Domonkin is the same Hamaya. For a while, he was staff photographer for the wartime propaganda magazine Famous Front. He quit because he objected to how his photographs were altered and used in that magazine. Snowland was a collection of photographs documenting life in a small rural village in Niigata Prefecture named Kuwatori Dani. It included photographs he had taken before and after the war, I say. From folkloristic perspective, this book has. Hamaya said of this work, it was a record of classic form of Japanese life. He said of extraordinary quality of this printing that his model was a brass-sized Paris Nui, by which he had been deeply moved in his youth time. Hamaya's work is documentary style, but more stylish than Domonkin's documentary photography, because he is a member of Magnum in end of 1950s to the early 60s. In the 1960s and early 1970s, two major currents emerged from photobooks published in the realism photography movement. The first was protest book created as a tool for directly promoting social change. Domonkin Chikuho no Kodomo Tachi, Children of Chikuho, published in 1960s, in one such work. It documented the effect of the closure of the coal mine in North Kyushu Island, as Japan shifted from coal to oil. These photo books printed on quote paper. The photo books sold for only 100 yen. More than 100,000 copies were sold, and its impact on society was enormous. Then the 1960s saw the production of many photo books, low cost 100 yen, documenting popular resistance to revising the US-Japan security treaty and other social protest movement. The end of 1960s and early 70s, the participants in student resistance movement produced their own photo books with the goal of transforming society. Here is an important example. Juten ni ichi to wa nani ka? What is October 21st? This day is a International Anti-War Day. It was produced as a special project in the member of the All Japan Student Photo Association, an alliance of student photographer craft throughout Japan. This book has very interesting photographic expression. These left side photographs are very bright and bokeh, out focused. And this is just like a realism work, a sequence. But we can see the very influence of provoke expression, but they don't know the provoke. Because I'm very close to a bit, because I am also a member of All Japan Student Photo Association in just this time. That we don't know, we have not interest in a photograph scene in Japan, the professional photographers work, like Kimura or some other. Just we do those photographic expression is only a mechanical, because we have not a big electric flash. So we should only night the lights. So the long exposure should be those expression what we can do. And this is a party of before the demonstrations. Those white dot is all helmets. The second major current that began in the end of 1950s was associated with the Vivo Photo Cooperative organized by Thomas Shome, Kawada Kikuji, Hosoe Eiko, and Narahara Ikko, and Sato Akira. Their work used a variety of expressive technique to capture complex reality in Japanese society that remained invisible in straight photography as domo. Their theme addressed social issue, but their expression was not documentary style. In 1961, Eiko Hosoe published Otoko to Onna, Man and Woman. This. His model were famous butoh dancer Hijikata Tatsumi and other dancers and models. And this photo book directly addressed the most fundamental human question, sex. Book design in which the photogravure printing with black backgrounds are prints and on the text pages. Contrast with the red and yellow, it's extremely modern. It's powerfully expressive raw physical eroticism. Another important photo book published in the 1960s was Kawada Kikuji's Chizu, the map. published in 1965. This work is truly exceptional, not just in Japan, but among photo books produced anywhere in the world. This book was designed by Kohei Sugiura. His design for the book was provocative in extreme. When the book was removed from its case, left side is a box, and the center is a folding case. Open this folding case, we can see the real photo book, just right side. Yeah, we can. When the book was removed from its case, and second black case was revealed, only when this case was opened on all four sides did the photo book itself appear. Every page in book was double folded, four pages spread. This is the pages spread pages, but we can spread left side and right side, four page spread like this. When two pages spread was opened, the second set is two pages spread appeared. This pattern is repeated throughout all photo book, like this. This opened that we appeared this. And this Japanese flag opened these images. This is atomic bomb peace dome in Hiroshima. The concept was to stimulate awareness that viewing photographs is special act as a performance. Originally, this book was intent to be published in two volumes, but because of publisher's situation, only single volume was produced. One two-volume edition, handmade by himself, is in a collection at the New York Public Library. The subjects in the photographs include a close-up, the cracks in the wall, this. That cracks of the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Dome, personal item of left behind the members of the kamikaze, and wrinkled Japanese flag and Coca-Cola bottles. All appeared one after the other in a photogravure prints dominated by deep black hue. They are symbol of Japan's post-war history in the wake of crime, Cold War. Here we should also consider Thomas Shomed's second photo book, Nippon, this, which published in 1967. It published by Shashin Publishing Company. This company was founded by Thomas Self. This original plan was published a series four volume, of which first is 1102 Nagasaki in 1966. This publisher is Shashin Doujinsha. Because the publishers went bankrupt, the next three volumes in the series were reorganized and published as a single volume of this photo book. As a result, this volume contained photographs from several series between 1945 to 1967. For example, that's Drifting Away, and this is Osore-san, and this is Asphalt, and this is Home, Ie, in Japanese. And this is Senryo, Occupations. And also, this is Senryo. Combining them in a single photo book, to which the title Japan was given, transformed them into a visual discourse of Japan's post-war years. In contrast, 1960s, when photobooks, broadly speaking, focused on social issue, photobooks in 1970s pursued private theme. They posed the fundamental question, what is photography? We might say that this period saw the dismantling of modern photography that emerged in 1930s. The photography that raised this question was a bleu bokeh, a blurred and out focus style. It appeared in the pages of Provoke, you know. This photography magazine published starting in 1968 by Taki Koji and Nakahira Takuma and Takanashi Yutaka and poet Okada Takahiko and Daido Moriyama, Moriyama Daido from second issue. Moriyama Daido's first book is this, Nippon Gekijo Shashincho Japan Theater. This was published in 1968, same age of Provoke. The book, designed by Tatsumi Shiro and text by Terayama Shuji, a reader of the avant-garde theater called Tenjo Sajiki. For this book, Moriyama assembled the photographs of actors associated with popular theater, like this, that he had previously published in a Kamera Mainichi magazine titled Nippon Gekijo, same. But it was confined to these out of the ordinary photographs. He also included many snapshots of everyday life in Tokyo City, this and this. Instead of consistent theme based on superficial meaning related to the subject of the photographs, these photobooks were focused on the photography itself. In 1970, Nakahira Takuma, one of the core members of Provoke, published Kitarubeki Kotoba no Tameni, For a Language to Come. The book design was Kimura Tsunehisa. He is an artist of photomontage, influenced by John Hartfield, political photomontage. Almost that photographs in a photo book was previously published in a magazine either Provoke and Design. And this was published in Provoke, the Design. Design is an art magazine, special focused in the design. Blurring created by the strong contrast and also grain, it's difficult to decide instantly what had been photographed. This style represented a direct rejection and dismantling of modern photography paradigm, in which the true aim of photography was highly precise, objective portrayal of the subject. These photographs are fuke, scape, landscape. This intense, I believe, how Nakahira saw the world. Then in 1971, Araki Nobuyoshi self-published Famous Sentimental Journey. This photo book, in contrast, printing the photo books by Daido, Moriyama, and Nakahira. This book has a weak, low contrast, whitey tone maintained throughout this book. We see an everyday scene and shot of this and shot of his wife from Araki's honeymoon. These shots are all honeymoon. It contained everything that Araki and his wife Yoko experienced, including the origin of Araki's love in desire. To Araki, that desire was also photography's starting point. In making these utterly private photographs to public, he was making a clear statement about what was missing in the social issue focus of modern photography. These three photo books can be seen, I believe, that setting of the course for the change of the photographic expression in Japan from 1960 through the 1970s. What they have in common is questioning that primordial origin of interest in photography, an issue abandoned by modern photography paradigm. This questioning of the modern was not, of course, restricted to photography. We see the same trend in poetry, novels, movies, and fine arts and other artistic genres. All were part of the same broad cultural context in which the student resistance movement of the 70s occurred. Starting early 1970s, important photo books can be divided into three broad categories. The first, the rediscovery of amateur photographer active in 1930s. Here we can point to Kuwabara Kineo's first photo book, Tokyo Showa 11, Tokyo 1936, published in 1974. This Kuwabara's snapshot work is very famous in the 1930s in the photo magazine, like Photo Times or Camera Art magazine. But after war, Kuwabara worked as an editor and a photo critic. So former generation or young generation photographers people of photographic world, Kuwabara is a photo editor and photo critics, not photographer. This, when in 1968, have the famous important photo exhibition, A Century of Photography. This exhibition organized in 1968 by Japan Photographers Society, JPS. That they have the committee for the exhibition. Member of the committee is Tomatsu Shomei and Taki Koji and Nakahira Takuma and others. An effort to reconstruct the history of photography in Japan. We have a history book, history of Japanese photography in 84 to 1945, published in 1971. This book is the most important history book of Japanese photography. That book, it depends on this exhibition, and this exhibition research discovered those Kuwabara Kineo and next Teiko Shiotani. This book was titled Teiko Shiotani Teiko Meisakushu, Shiotani Teiko Masterpiece Album in 1973. This collection work was pictured. He is a very important pictorial photographer in 1920 to the 1930s. This photo book supervised by Shoji Ueda, and this published in 1975. The Shiotani is also discovered in that exhibition of a century of photography. The second, this is Shiotani's famous work, Landscape of Weather Report. This is deformed. And the second category is photobooks that sum up in activities of photographers active in 1960s. Examples include this is Suzuki Kiyoshi's Soul and Soul, published in 1972. And this book is like a self-portrait of his career. This is just a self-portrait of photographer Kiyoshi Suzuki. And also that Takanashi Yutaka's titled Toshie Towards the City, published in 1974. This is also a collection of 1960s. These photographs include in the Provoke first issue. And also this book has a second small book, Tokyo Ite. This is main book. This is an alternate book. This book is published in 19. This series, Tokyo Ite, was published in 1966 in the Camera Mainichi magazine, 1966 January. Only in the magazine, in this time, 1974, was published as a photo book. And this is a Tsuchida Hiromi's Zokushin, God of Earth, published in 1970. Six, and this Morinaga Jun Kawa Ruie River Its Shadow of Shadows in 1978. Those two works are photographed in 1960s or early 70s. The third category is photo books published by younger photographers whose career was just started in the 1970s. Here we can point to the Tsukiji Hitoshi, the Suichokujo no Ryoiki. Perpendicular territory, self-published in 1975. Just a moment. This is only the album. This book is too small, so I can handle this. This is the first page. This book is always three page. And spread the left side, we can see two photographs and separate just three page. And we can different pair of triplets. And yes, we see that always three. But the three pairs is always different and just changing, a little bit changing, shifted, images were shifted, changing. It's very easy binding because, yeah. Maybe designers can easy to understand this book, a construction. This book has two books. You can see two books. So folded every page, you can see. This style was, book was designed by Nobuyoshi Kikuchi. He is a famous book designer now. But this is his quite early work, like this. And second, an issue to Miyako's famous apartment, published in 1978. This book was designed by Tsunehisa Kimura. He is also designer of Nakahira's book. This book is very important way of the printing system. This is copper half-tone printing. Copper half-tone printing is in this time, in the mid-1970s, that very, very old one. In that 1970s, Japanese printing conditions are changing to the offset printing. Gravure printing is stopped. Only a magazine in the rotaries, a rotary gravure was remained, but the flat gravure was almost lost. And almost, and also that copper half-ton printing is almost lost in this mid-70s. But Tsunehisa Kimura went to printing, that's copper half-ton printing, this Ishiuchi's apartment. Maybe very good for effect for these photographs. And the last one, the Keizo Kitajima's Photo Express Tokyo. This is introduced as 3 volumes, but this are a complete volume, just 12 volumes. This book was published in 1979. He's a member of CAMP. CAMP is established by Daido Moriyama and his workshop graduates, workshop Shashin Gakko, workshop photo school. Kitajima is the graduates of Moriyama's workshop school. And this book was published every month, like a magazine, monthly magazine. That depend on in a photo exhibition in camp. In this year, Keizo Kitajima held every month his one-man show in the camp gallery. And so he issued that those photo book every month. What in it, there are all these photo books published at a different phase in the history of Japanese photography have in common. Photo books are not catalogs. We are only intermediaries, media for communicating images. We might say, instead that printed photographs itself becomes an unmediated means of creative expression. Whether we are talking about historic photographs and the photograph shoot yesterday, a photo book is a form of a creative expression equivalent to an original print. Because, however, photographers in Japan, unlike their colleagues in the US, had not generally embraced the couple of the original print in the 1970s. It was only from mid-80s that photo books were explicitly positioned as a creative work on par with original prints. For Japanese photographers like photo books in 1930s, for a photo book is the best way to express the photo book, not original print. It's I introduced the first that realism photo movement is also. Realism photo movement is the most best way of the publishing. Publishing is the best way of the photographs because their intense photographs are very social one. Nonetheless, the photo books were created as positioned in distinctive mode of creative expression of the world of Japanese photographs. Because since rise of modern photography in 1930s, a coherent collection of photographs, a photo book, has been regarded as the most outstanding mode of photographic expression. Photographers in each period since then have proved and explored its potential with the results we have seen today. Thank you very much.